What's cracking, YouTube? It's Manny Slugs, aka Manny the Mexican, aka too lazy to work while simultaneously taking your job. And today we have an unexpected unboxing because I was expecting a whole different package, which I got, you know, one of them. But I also got this one, and I don't remember ordering from Foot Locker. I've ordered other ones, but I don't remember a specific one from Foot Locker. And I'm real curious. Cut myself. Real curious about this one, because I have no idea. I mean, I have some ideas which ones it might have been, but I guess we're gonna find out. See that? I was trying to put the knife down, but it wasn't my EDC knife. EDC, man. It was EDC, everyday carry. Okay. So, it's another unboxing. We're gonna see what it is because I just kind of forgot a little bit. I do a little shopping, you know, the steamy cocoa pop came through, and you know, this, if I don't remember it, it was probably maybe like a month ago, 3 weeks or so. Let these know how we can flow. I'm playing. Okay. But yeah, thank you for your purchase. We're so happy you found something you love. How was your experience? We want to know. Visit our local store or our website for customer service to show. I don't say that. Or give us feedback or the survey you email us. You're important to us. Thanks for being our customer. 100% satisfaction guaranteed. Thank you. Because sneakers. So put that aside. I like when they give you that. I like the stickers more. Oh yeah, that is what it is. That is exactly what it is. It is exactly what it is. Nah, but for real. Look at that. If you're an old school sneakerhead, you know about that one. Like I said before in a previous video, I had, you got the Pump It Up in the top. You got a Reebok Custom Fit, the Pump. Reebok Custom Fit on the side. The bottom, we got the box is made of recycled material and is recyclable, reuse, or recycle Adidas. Whoop-de-whoop-de-woo. In case you need to know about all that on the bottom of the box. Excuse me for the coughing. I've been doing that since I was like in third, fourth grade. And I could never stop. Yeah, but okay. But like I said in a previous video, these are one of the only shoes that I remember as a kid getting brand new. I mean, I usually got my older brother's hand-me-downs. I would get all the Converse, but there was never any Jordans in the mix because we didn't grow up too wealthy, you know what I'm saying? We grew up in the ghetto a bit, you know what I'm saying? And you like if you know me when I used to make music, or I still do make music, but once my pops passed away and, you know, my kids was born and all that, it's a lot of priorities changed. But yeah, so this is one of the first shoes that I actually remember getting new as a kid, and I was so pumped up over it because it was it at the time. If you had these, you was it at the time. I kind of remember. I'm thinking it's like third or fourth grade. Honestly, I don't remember. I have to research. But here we go. Oh, that opens up with a little. Okay. Okay, I already see that they are the darker ones. The ones I believe I got when I was a kid, my memory's pretty freaking good, is the white ones. Those are the ones I believe I had. I had the black. I might have. I remember the shoes, for sure. Come on, man. You come with a little scuff, man. Should not talk on scuff, man. That's not a game. Okay, So right off top, oh Lord, this is so cool. So right off top, you have, I'm just trying to look for any mistakes, any, you got a little white speckle on my leather right there. Let me see, wait for it to, wait for it to adjust and focus. I don't know if you can see that. If I had the macro lens, I'll take a picture on the macro lens and I'll show you that later. There is a little white speckle, but then you have the Reebok, the pump in the back. You got the Hexalite trademark. You have the tag on the side letting you know the size and whatnot. And then my most memorative part of the whole freaking shoe is that bad boy right there. Let's try to let us focus in. I should have did this earlier in the day, but it didn't come till later. But yeah, that. You was able to pump that bad boy in and it would tighten your shoe. And you felt like you was about to, you know, conquer the world. And I believe this is what releases it. I'm not sure. I have not put the shoe on yet. I'll give you an on-foot review as well as soon as I make sure that these are completely with the game. Yeah, I know I'm wearing Jordan right now and I got the Reebok, but I'm pretty sure everybody knows who ran the game before Nike, and it was Reebok. Adidas was there, Puma too, but Reebok had a significant influence. That was the left shoe. We gonna go to the right shoe. Like I said, I always gotta do the left and the right, because you might say, well, it's a left, it's the same shoe. No, it's not the same shoe. It's a left shoe and it's a right shoe. So you gotta make sure everything's, you know, that's a little part I was talking about in the beginning. It's a little tiny scuff right there. Let me see if I can turn my lights this way. It's a little scuff mark right there. That's just dust. Oh, and right here on the tongue, it says Reebok Basketball. Reebok Basketball. This is just the normal sizes. This is a personal pair, so it's a 9. You don't really have no shoe tree. It's just the good old classic paper in the shoe. But, hell yeah, it is here. Oh, we gotta do it again, right? Remember, all the time you gotta do Cholo version. Cholo version. But yeah, don't fall off, box. Okay, so that is the Reebok Pump Omni 2, I believe. And, one thing I've got. Oh, you can't see it anyway. I'm just gonna take a picture and show you. I always try to do this inside thing and it never works out. And it looks pretty cool. It says Reebok the Pump with the TM, the trademark. And it only comes with one pair of laces. I don't see anything else. There's nothing, no indication that it comes with another set of laces. So as far as we know, this is it. This is the freaking Reebok. This is the Pump coming back out. And I think they did another one in 2016, you know, my bad, don't quote me on that right now. But, oh, my bad, this is the bottom. Oh, look at that, look at the bottom. That is flame. Flame. That's like kind of my favorite part of the shoe sometimes, is the bottom, but that's also the part that obviously gets the most dirtiest, but it is beautiful. Oh, it's a little bit dark there. Don't tell me somebody wore them and stepped on them. You know, didn't step with them. I hope not. Cholo version, but that is what it is. You guys got any questions, comments, make sure to like, subscribe, hit that bell to get the notifications anytime I upload another video. Like I said, hit the like button, because that helps me get up there a little bit more. And I want to start doing autograph giveaways. If you know me from Facebook, you know I got a moving company as well. And through this moving company, I get a lot of donations. One of the donations was a big chunk of autographs. And it was from, I think he passed away. It was like a Raider official. This dude put the autograph signings together. I mean, I got lists and lists of, he's saying, okay, it's just insane. This is a whole nother video. But what I'm getting at is eventually I want to start doing like autograph giveaways. You know, maybe when I hit a 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to just randomly give out some autographs. Most of the autographs I got is Raiders. It's like 50% Raiders, 30% Niners. Then I got like maybe some Steelers, some Chargers. I think a Carolina Panther or two. Some golf, a couple golf ones, some baseball ones, but I got a lot of stuff. So, and it don't really mean crap to me. It's just sitting here, it's collecting dust, so I don't really mind doing it. So, for future reference, I will be giving out autographs from NFL players, maybe some baseball players, but mostly NFL players. For once I hit the 1,000 subscriber mark, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to update it then. Then by then I'll have a much clearer idea of how I'm going to do this. But keep it going. Keep it commenting. If you don't like it, if you like it, if you want to see something different, if you want to see me do a different cholo version of the shoe. Oh, that's a good one actually right there. But let me know, man. Let me know. This is what we're doing. This is what we're trying to get going. I mean, like I said, I got a moving company aside. I do photography, videography, edit. I do the works, man. I'm a jack of all trades. I like legal money. You know what I'm saying? I like legal money. I don't want to be making illegal money and watching my back the whole time. I got kids, and if you know me, you know me. You know I've lived that whole life before, and it's not the business right now. This is the business. This is the business. I'm reliving my childhood with these shoes. Not this big. I mean, damn, I wish my childhood shoes was this big. I'd be tall. I'm a short-ass Mexican. But it is what it is, man. Let me go and do that, like, you know, just showcase it a few different ways. But if there's anything you want me to, anything else you want me to do, oh, I seen a last person that commented want me to do the Lady of Heaven, Heaven's Lady or something, wanted me to do the reaction to the trailer, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. I didn't watch it yet. I did YouTube it and wanted to just see if, you know, and it's something legit. It's not some weirdo stuff. But yeah, so we gonna end the video with a thank you to everybody. Thank you to society out there that's tuning in with us. It's giving me the likes. It's giving me the views. That's keeping me inspired to do what I do. And that rhymed again. So, yeah. Sex Nate Society. Manny Slugs. Manny the Mexican. Too lazy to work while simultaneously taking your jobs. Let's get it in.